Welcome back here to Up North at 4. The gentlemen joining me to my left, we got Andy, Brian, and Erik. The Basement Pact is what you guys call yourself. First question, the Basement Pact, where does this come from, Andy?
Well, we work together, okay. And we've always been confined to a basement. That's usually where our workplace is, so we formed our pact in a basement. We are the Basement Pact.
I love it.
Okay,
love
and it. In this basement, things come out of this basement, right?
Yeah.
And one of those things is this game in front of us. What is this game?
So this game is called Racket Sugar Rush.
Okay.
Racket in the sense that you're trying to be a racketeer. You're trying to collect and run a racket on certain things. So
okay.
The game originated, if you're familiar, there's an old commodity trading game called Pit, in which you trade like wheat and barley and things like that.
Okay.
So the gameplay is kind of based on that, and we kind of gave it a modern version, and there's some limitations to that game. You can only play with five, and we wanted to get large groups of people all playing together kind of in a frenzy. So we kind of updated the theme, we changed some of the rules, added more people, and kind of came up with this game.
Okay, I'm curious though, were you guys going in saying, let's create a game, or is it one of those things that happened organically, you're messing around, you start making
up rules? Are there beers involved?
Yeah, how does this come to be here? I'm just curious.
Well, this is a game that I kind of came up with a long time ago, like in high school, when we got together as like a youth group and played games and things like that, and found out that, you know, we can only play this commodity trading game with five people, and it was kind of uninteresting, the theme, and so I came up with this game and just played it with just a close-knit group of friends.
Yeah.
And so a few years later, I said, hey, you know, I have a card game, and we played it a few times, and they decided, hey, this might be something that other people want to play. Yeah, this could be a thing. We should see what we can do about it. So,
okay. So
they jumped on board and
we were able to push them a little bit.
If it was up to me, it probably wouldn't have happened. So I'm glad these guys.
So you were friends before.
Yes.
And you're still friends now.
So far.
I just wanted to make sure. So I'm just curious though. You guys have a Kickstarter going. Do you guys want to get this out there? Right. What's sort of the vision that you guys have for this game long term?
Sure. So we have this game. We're trying to get it funded on Kickstarter. If you don't know what Kickstarter is, a crowdfunding platform that you can go on and kind of pledge and help people get their projects going. Most of the funds we're going to raise from our Kickstarter, we're going to go right into production of the game. It's also looked at as a pre-order of the game. If you go on a Kickstarter, you can get the first copies of the game that come out. It'll also help us fund the production of further copies of the game.
Okay, perfect. So, I think it's time. It's one thing to talk about. It's another thing to play it and experience it firsthand.
All right.
So I say we set up a little demo game.
Sure.
Geoff and I can see how this thing works firsthand. But in the meantime, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back here in Up North at 4.
I need a black belt.
Welcome back. So Geoff and I hanging out with the Basement Pack. I'm just going to say that. It's a lot of years going through all your guys' names. So we're talking about a card game you guys created. It's Racket Sugar Rush.
Yep.
How does this game work?
Okay.
Walk us through this.
We'll run through it. So there are 10 different types of candy, and you can, based on the amount of people that are playing, that's how many you use. So since we have five of us, we're gonna pick five. So I'm just going to randomly pick five different types of candy. We'll have licorice and peanut butter cups, chocolate bars, gummy bears, and caramels.
Oh, okay. I'll have him. Great call.
So now we shuffle those.
Yep. So Brian's going to shuffle those up. And so there is a version of the game where it comes with these extra cards, a candy jar and a dentist. Those are kind of wild cards that you could throw in as well. You do want the candy jar if you're going to win. You don't want the dentist ever. So that's kind of...
You don't
want to hang on to that.
Like
you want to pass it around.
Candy and the dentist don't mix. So.
Right. So if there's any dentists out there watching, we apologize.
You can go to the dentist. Just when you're trying to run a racket on candy, you want to avoid the dentist. Yep.
Perfect.
So Brian's going to get them shuffled, and then we're all just basically going to deal them all out. So everybody, I'll deal a couple at a time just to make it go a little faster. But we're going to deal all the cards out. And then the idea is that you want to try to collect all the same cards of one candy before somebody else does. So in your hand, there is going to be a mix. You got nine cards, and they're all going to be mixed up. So you kind of want to sort them by candy, whatever you think you're going to kind of collect the most of. You can see that maybe you have one of one kind that you're going to want to get rid of.
Okay.
And when you trade, now you're going to trade blindly, so you're not going to see anyone else's cards.
It's not turn-based either, so it's kind of a free-for-all once it gets started.
So once we go, everybody's going.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
You can trade in sets or pairs.
It's
so
like the stock market.
Yep. So, for example, I have, I'll just show you my hand. But I have three gummy bears, I have a caramel, a peanut butter cup, and I have four licorice. So I might want to start collecting licorice because I already have four of those. And I want to get rid of these as one, because it's by itself. I can get rid of these gummy bears as one, or two, or three.
Got it.
So I'm doing the same with you.
So you face down, and you ask, you say how many cards you're looking for, which is how many you give. So it's just a swap with the first person that wants your card.
So is it like a one-to-one swap then?
If I want two, I got to give up two.
And the goal is to get rid of all the cards, or to have the
most sets? The goal is to get all of one kind.
All of one kind.
So if I say
I have two cards I want to trade, if anybody has two cards they want to trade, they put their two down and we exchange cards.
All right, you know, I'll take you on that.
Okay, all right.
I want two.
I'll give you. Anybody got one?
I'll go one.
Okay. Oh, so we're just going.
Yep. You go.
Oh my God! Dropping cards. Peanut butter. All right, I got one.
I'll take two.
I'm crumbling under the pressure. I'll go one.
So how many other four total of each category? Four?
No, there's nine. So you want to get all nine of the same.
Two.
Who's got one here?
Whole hand.
Wait, two.
That's mine.
I'll go two.
There's nine of each.
So this is just constant go.
Yep.
I'll take two.
I'll go two.
Oh, I got licorice again. Okay.
I'll go three.
I got two. I'll go three.
I'll go two.
I got two. Someone's got
two.
I'll go back to two.
I'll go back to two.
What if no one wants your cards?
I got three.
Yep. Someone so now three?
We're three. Oh gosh.
Anybody with
I'll
three?
Do one.
I got three. Three.
Two.
So we're just going.
Yep. You're just going.
So racket. So I.
Oh, you won.
So you call racket when you get all the same kind.
Okay.
I ended up with all nine.
You got all the
chocolate.
Yep.
So then, are each card worth a point then at the end?
So I would get 8 points in the log, the game log, the score sheet, to put towards a final score at the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you can either go by, you know, you would say we're going to play till we hit 50 points, or we're going to play for a half hour. It's kind of up to you how much time you want to do. But so that's one round. Brian's got 8 points. We got none.
Okay.
So
now we reshuffle.
Yep.
And then bring all the cards back in.
Well,
pick five again.
Yep. Yep.
Oh.
I'm curious. We didn't use them, but then you were mentioning we have the wild cards here, right? The dentist, the candy jar.
Yep. Just, so we could,
how does this come into play?
So we could shuffle those in, and then in your hand, let's say, one person's going to have an extra, and I'm going to have an extra. So I'm always going to want to get rid of that dentist. I can pass him off with others.
He wants the dentist.
Yep. But this is always negative points.
Okay.
So this is a negative couple points whether you win or not.
Yep. And so there will be two people that have an extra card. So if I ended up with all nine plus the candy jar, it's a bonus.
He doubles. Right? Okay. He doubles. He gets 16.
You double your whole point.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Right. If I didn't have an extra card and someone else had an extra card, I could also win with eight plus the wild card candy jar.
Okay. If that's how many cards you had. But if you had that, and let's say it went out like that, and he has all his chocolate, you got stuck with the candy jar. You didn't win. You're left holding the jar.
Okay.
You lose points also.
Oh, so the candy jar is like...
That's a very wild. Sometimes you want it, sometimes you don't.
It's the hand that feeds you. It's also the hand that...
So like your fantasy league this week, that you're a loser if you have that.
Okay, I just...
This
seems very off topic, but Geoff and I are going head-to-head in fantasy football this week, and he's been talking so much smack. It's disgusting, and I thought we'd just have a fun day.
What's your record? What's your record?
It doesn't matter. You know what? If he's going to keep bringing this up, I feel like it's only right we play another round and I try to beat Jeff.
All right.
Is that fair?
Okay. All right, let's go away.
We'll take those out just to keep it simple.
Okay. So all the cards go back in, right?
Yep, shuffle them up. Used.
I was two cards away.
I was a few cards away, I think.
So if you're playing with another person, if you have a six player, then you get another set of nine candy cards. Maybe grab the lollipops and throw them in. But so you just play with the amount of candy, with the amount of people you have.
But you don't want the dentist.
Don't want the dentist.
No. Right.
Do you want to play with those? Should we throw those in?
I think just throw them in.
Okay.
All right. Geoff wants to play a little. He's wild.
Let's throw this in.
He's feeling good.
He's wild with it.
How much time we have left?
I don't know. This is fun.
Have a good time.
I love it.
Let's go into Jeopardy, you know.
See, this reminds me, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Dutch Blitz, if you guys have ever played that game before. Just it's very go, you know, you're trying to get rid of all the cards. It's hectic. That's what it reminds me of.
Well, that's part of the fun, right? It reminds me of like a speed, like spoons on the table, you know?
It is good.
Yeah.
So you always wanted to get rid of the dentist card.
All right, well, hopefully.
And you can pair them up with other cards.
Nate has a dentist card.
You can do it by itself.
Okay, I'm looking. We got to organize our cards.
You two got an extra since I was the dealer.
Oh, okay.
You have an extra. You
can get the extra cards.
Bar. Someone shuffled better this time. Okay, we have 10 seconds, so we're out of time.
Oh, 10 seconds.
All right.
We got to go.
Do we have to go? I think we do. All right. Gentlemen.
Okay.
But in the meantime, all right, Racket, Sugar Rush. People can buy this now. You guys are hoping to get money. How does this all work out here?
You can go to racketcards.com, and there's a banner at the top to go right to our Kickstarter.
Perfect.
And then from there, there's we have 7 or 8 tiers that you can choose from that'll give you different rewards based on what you want
to. Yep. It's basically like putting in a pre-order. So you can either go to racketcards.com or go to kickstarter.com and search for, Racket Cards.
Yep. Right. Congratulations,
well,
guys.
This is so much fun. I just love this whole idea. This thing is so much fun.
All right, I got 3.
Might have to pre-order, might have to pre-order a pack for Geoff.
For Christmas. Meantime.
We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Someone take my 3.
Hey, here's 2.
Here's 2. I got 2 for you.
I see a red door and I want it painted black.